Learning the ropes of Microsoft Teams can be tricky. Where do all of the most basic settings and options even live? Well, let's find out. Hey everybody, my name's Kyle, and today we're gonna take a look at one of the first areas you should become familiar with in Microsoft Teams, the profile dashboard. You can find the profile dashboard in the top right corner of Microsoft Teams, where you should see your picture or initials. Click that circle to drop down the profile dashboard. Here, you'll see the profile with which you're signed in, as well as an option to change your picture. This change will be reflected across all of Microsoft 365. Below this, you'll see a number of options and settings. The first option is setting your status. Hovering over the status lets you choose between options like available, busy, and do not disturb. Your status also changes based on your activity, presenting or in a meeting, for example, and based on your status set in Outlook. If you're out of office, for example, that will be reflected in Microsoft Teams. You can also set a status message for colleagues to see. Write your message, choose to have it display when you're messaged, and choose a time to have it automatically clear. Below your photo, you'll see some other account options. Some users might be using the same email address with multiple organizations, or may have been invited to a team as a guest. Those users can switch and see the other organization's teams, channels, chats, and meetings with just a few clicks. We've also recently launched Teams for personal accounts, opening a new window in which users can chat or call friends and family instead of work colleagues. Below your status is saved. We'll cover saved in a different video. Below saved is settings. These settings manage your individual desktop instance of Teams. General settings has the color theme, application options like opening Teams upon launch, and turning on the option to open meetings in new windows. You'll also find language options here. Privacy, devices, and permissions all manage how Teams interacts with others and with your PC. Notifications gives minute controls over how you receive information in Microsoft Teams. Choose how often you receive a missed activity email, if notifications play sounds, and set how you see info from Teams and channels, chats, meetings, and more. You can even tag specific people to receive notifications when they become available. Finally, Calls manages settings related to voice over IP calling, if your organization is set up for that. Below settings is Zoom, which can change your view of Teams and reset your Zoom level. Next is keyboard shortcuts. Keyboard warriors will find a wealth of shortcuts inside of Microsoft Teams, from shortcuts to jump from layout to layout, reply to a thread, and toggle mute on and off during a call. Below shortcuts is About, full of info on Microsoft Teams, version, legal info, privacy statements, and more. Below, you can check the desktop client of Teams for updates. Updates are checked periodically, and Teams will rarely, if ever, need to close and restart to install updates. Finally, you'll find a link to download the mobile app for Microsoft Teams and the option to sign out. The profile dashboard is your one-stop shop for quick settings, changing your status, and more. But there is a wealth to uncover inside of Microsoft Teams. To find out more, be sure to check out this entire series of Microsoft Teams tutorials. We'll talk to you next time. Looking for more info to help you sell even better? Head on over to Expert Zone, Microsoft's online learning platform for courses and classes on all things Microsoft.